Congratulations on taking the first step towards starting your business visibility on YouTube. My name's Anita Wong, and you signed up for this training because you want to learn how to move your Instagram Reels over to YouTube as YouTube Shorts. So briefly, before we start the actual how-to of how you can do that, I just want to go over why YouTube is such a powerful social media platform and often overlooked by business owners because they're a little bit scared of the polished YouTuber sort of like impression that they get. So first of all, YouTube and Google are actually connected. And what happened was that Google saw how amazing YouTube was and decided to buy it. And that's created this amazing link between the two. So when you search on Google for maybe an answer to your problem, or you're looking up something, not only will Google look at all of the websites on the internet, but it will also dive into YouTube to see if it can find a video answer over there. And that's where the power of YouTube comes into helping you as a business owner increase your visibility and have the ability to attract an audience to you that will connect with you and even maybe become a lead or a new client or a new service or somebody who buys your products. So that's why I'm really passionate about helping business owners who are a little bit nervous about actually stepping in front of the camera, a little bit nervous about the tech, and a little bit nervous about the jargon out there around how to actually use YouTube as a business tool to generate leads and create money for your business. So I'm actually 50 years old, and I know what it's like to try and learn a new tool when everything just seems a little bit overwhelming and you're not really sure of the lingo that people are using. And when you look on YouTube for a video to show you how to do something, it goes too quickly and it doesn't actually really answer your question. So this is where I come in, and this is where you come in, because when you step into YouTube and start sharing your passion with the world, you'll be able to answer the questions to your ideal audience. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is if you actually take that step into YouTube in the first place. So using your short video that you've already created on Instagram that you know is working for you and transferring it over to YouTube is a win-win situation, because if you're already growing an audience on Instagram with that content, then I'm 100% sure you'll be able to grow an audience over on YouTube with that content. Now, the easiest way for me to show you how to do this transfer is to jump into the desktop and show you it in real time. One thing to say, that if you are creating your Instagram Reels on your mobile phone using your video camera and you store your Instagram Reel into your camera roll, then you can just use that Instagram Reel without having to go through the next step that I'm about to show you. If, however, you create your Instagram Reels using the Instagram app and the copy of the reel is inside of Instagram, then it is best to remove that video without the branding. And that's the first step that I'm going to show you how to do. Now, there is a check sheet that accompanies this video, and you can see it right here. And if you haven't got that, then there'll be a link around the video that you can download it. And it goes through those steps in there as well, so you can tick off what you've done. Some of the steps on the check sheet you only need to do once, but once you've done them, then you've got it all sorted forever. And those checks are like downloading the mobile YouTube app and the mobile YouTube Studio app to your phones, because they're really useful to see how your YouTube Shorts are performing on your new YouTube channel or your new revamped YouTube channel. Okay, so let's jump into my desktop and I'll show you how to do everything. Okay, so here we are on my Instagram account. Now, I already know which Instagram Reel I want to use, so I'm just going to go ahead and find that. Now, what you need to do, if you're not sure which Instagram Reel you want to use, and I would suggest using one that's been performing quite well, I would go into your mobile phone and have a look at your analytics. So go into the professional dashboard, click on your analytics option, click on Reels, and then search which is the best performing reel. I would suggest go by reach rather than plays. Okay, so just quickly to show you how to find out what your best performing reel is, you go to the professional dashboard on your Instagram account, and then you click on the analytics chart. And then if you scroll down, you can see you have the option for Reels. Go ahead and click that. Okay, so like I said just now, it's probably better to actually look at reach rather than plays. The default is plays. So what I would suggest you do is come up here to this little toggle and go to the metric option and go to reach and then apply. Now what this will do is it will change the configuration to show the best performing. And then I would go for the last 6 months so that you've got quite recent content. And as you can see, I've got one here that's had nearly 3,000 plays. So I'm going to go for that one. So here I am on my Instagram, and the reel I want to use is this one here, which has nearly 3,000. So what I want to do with this is I want to click on it and I want to get the link to this particular reel. So to do that, what we do is we click the three dots and we go copy link. So now what we need to do is we need to come over here to this new tab, and we need to go to this option which says SnapInsta.app. Okay, so it's SnapInsta.app, and that will be in the check sheet that I've given you alongside this particular training. Then all we need to do is paste the URL into the area and click download. Now, what it's going to do is it's going to get that video, and what it's going to do is it's going to make that video so that it doesn't have any branding on it whatsoever. So I'm just going to move myself over again, and as you can see at the bottom it says download video, so I'm going to go ahead and click download video.
So how many steps
I'm just going to pause that, and down the bottom here where these three little dots are, if you click that, it gives you the option to download. So go ahead and click download, and it's going to download this video to your computer. As you can see, it's got here. So what I would do, so that you know what it is, I would label that. And I'm going to save it to my desktop because I'm going to upload it straight away. You may want to save it to one of your files on your computer so you can find it easier. But for this, I'm going to just pop it onto my desktop. So go ahead and click save. And it's going to save that as an MP4 video on your computer. So then what we need to do now is we'll go over to YouTube. So go to youtube.com and it will take you to the homepage of YouTube. And in order for you to find your channel, what one needs to do is we need to come up to the top. And as you can see a profile picture of me up here. Go ahead and click that and click on your channel. Now, if you don't see you here, or if that's blank and you're not sure which channel to use, click the switch account option and you'll be able to see which channel you want to use. Once you've done that, come back here and click your channel, and it's going to take you to your channel so that you're on the right place in order to upload. Your YouTube channel might look a little bit different to mine because mine has been optimized with a YouTube banner at the top. It's got a name and my profile picture, and it's also got a welcome video. And I've also got videos on the homepage of my YouTube channel. So don't worry if you're not seeing that on yours. It's probably just because you haven't optimized it as yet. And that's something that we can go through at a later date. So by all means, come over to my channel and give it a subscribe. And, you know, obviously there are quite a few useful videos in here that you might find helpful as well. Now, in order for you to upload that video to YouTube, you probably just want to check that everything is okay with it. So what I would suggest you do is you go to the actual video in question and just double check that it's playing okay. So here you can see on the screen that that's my video that I've downloaded. And as you can see on it, there's no Instagram logo. As you can see, there's no logo whatsoever. And when I play it, I've got my audio. So that's something that you just want to double check before you upload it so that you know exactly what you're uploading. Okay, so now that we've got our video and it's working perfectly, this one is me speaking, so I don't have any copyright issues. If, however, you're using trending audio on your Instagram reel, then you may need to just check whether there's any copyright restrictions on it. And we can do that when we go through the process in a moment. Okay, so we've got the video, we know it plays, and we know it doesn't have any branding on. So now we're going to upload it into YouTube as a YouTube short, and we're going to set it as private so that we can let YouTube check to make sure there's no copyright restrictions. So what we need to do is we already know that we're on our YouTube channel, tick. We already know that we've got our Instagram reel ready to go up, tick. So all we need to do is come up here to this option where it says create. Go ahead and click that. and we're going to upload a video. So go ahead and click upload video. It's going to allow you to go and choose that video from your file. So select files. I know it's on my desktop and I'm going to click open and it's going to upload it. Okay, so as you can see, YouTube has pulled the video up into this area. Now, this is the upload area. Now, there will be some things on here that you don't see because my YouTube channel is monetized. So you won't see this ad suitability here, okay? And you won't see this check either because these are all to do with my YouTube channel being monetized. What you will see is this title here. Now, this has just pulled it from the file name that I wrote when I downloaded it onto my computer. So you really want this to be in relation to what the video says. So the title needs to be what your Instagram title might have been. So whatever you used on your Instagram account, you could, if you wanted to, use that on your YouTube. So here I put, how many steps do your prospective clients need to take to connect, subscribe, or buy from you? So that might be too long, but what I might do is just copy this first bit and put that over on YouTube. Now you can have 100 characters, so I'm going to put that in there, and that's like an enticing thing. So how many steps? Okay, so how many steps ... does it take for your leads to connect with you? And that's what I'm going to do for my title. Now if you want to, you can put a description of your video in here. So you could take the description that you had in your Instagram account. Now you might have had more description there than I have. So go ahead and just copy that and pop that in. And as you can see, you can have 500 characters for this area as well. So go ahead and just pop that in. Now what you can do in this area is put just a couple of hashtags. What happens with YouTube, which is a little bit different to Instagram, is that you can have three hashtags showing up under your title. Now you can usually see these more when it is a longer video, but for YouTube Shorts, what we can do is we can put those three hashtags in the description. And as you can see, when I'm typing them in, it comes up and tells you how many videos are on that hashtag and how many channels are doing that. And you can have up to three here. Okay, so also in YouTube, which you may not be aware of, is that you can actually group your YouTube Shorts into catalogs of videos, and they're called playlists on YouTube. So you can go ahead and select a playlist if you want, or in this section, you can click the button. If you haven't got a playlist, you can see it says new playlist, and you can go ahead and create a playlist for your YouTube Shorts if you want. I'm not going to put mine in a playlist for now because this is just for this training. Okay, so there is one more thing here, the audience setting. So there is a new rule. Regardless of your location, you're legally required to comply with the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, COPPA, and or other laws. So you're required to tell YouTube whether your content has been made for children. If it isn't, which I'm probably sure it isn't, make sure you click no, it's not made for kids. If it is made for children, then you do have to legally click that it is, and YouTube will put some minor restrictions on your content, and you'll have to decide whether that's something that you need to address. But for now, just make sure you choose whether it's made for kids or it's made for adults. And then all you need to do is click next. And what will happen is that YouTube will go through the process. So just skip this one because this won't be applicable for you. I will just have to quickly do this. Now, it will give you the options for video elements. Now, I would just leave these off for now because a YouTube short is a short video and I don't think any of these are applicable. So just skip over these. Checks, this is where this is quite useful. You see on mine, there's no copyright issues found. And for me, it's suitable for ads. Now, for you, you can check here whether there's any copyright issues, and hopefully there isn't, and it will say no issues found. That's where, if you've got trending music, it will do that check for you. Sometimes it might take a little bit longer to do this check. So what I suggest you do is do what I'm about to do so that you can actually upload it, let YouTube do the checks, and then come back in and schedule it for later. So go ahead and click next. And this is the visibility. So on YouTube Shorts, you don't get an option to choose the thumbnail. It's not available. So you just get whatever's shown on the screen as it goes up into the YouTube app. Now here we have save as private, save as unlisted. Now this is really good. You see it says here, select this setting and wait a couple of hours to see if any monetization or visibility issues are found. So this is what I would put it as for you as well, just to make sure that you don't have any copyright infringements and things like that. And all we do then is go ahead and click save. And what that will do is it will take that video which you've originally had on Instagram and put it into your YouTube channel ready and waiting for you to go. And it will automatically come to this page on your channel, and this is where you can see all of your content. So this is the video I've just put up, and as you can see, it's unlisted, so it's ready to go without any problems. What you can do now is either check that the copyright is all okay for you and come back in to the pencil option, and that's going to enable you to change the setting so that you can schedule it. So here you can see it's unlisted at the moment. If I click that, I can actually come down here where it says schedule, and I can change the date. So let me change that to today, and I'm going to do, say, like 6 p.m. and then all you need to do is click done, and then remember to click the save option up here at the top, and it's all set for you, ready to go out. And that's all you need to do in order for you to take your Instagram reel from Instagram and upload it onto YouTube. So as a little bonus, I'll just show you how to go into the YouTube studio and do what we've just done on the desktop, but just optimize the video here. So the YouTube app will be on your phone, probably just because that's what it comes with. The YouTube Studio app might not be. So if you're not sure how to find that and you haven't already uploaded it to your account, you just need to go to the App Store or to any area where you upload your app. So if you're using an Android or another type of phone, just go to where the apps are and just type in YouTube Studio. As you can see, it's here. And of course, if you've already got it, go to the App Store and just update it to the most up-to-date version. And then once you've got it, open it up and I'll just show you where to find that uploaded video so that you can go in and optimize it. So all you'd need to do is come here to the content and then go along to the short option. And this is going to bring up that video. So as you can see, that's the video at the top. So when I click that video at the top, so as you can see, there's this little pencil mark at the top. So when I click on that, that's going to open up the options on my mobile phone. And as you can see, I've got my title at the top. I've got that description that we put in. If you click it, you can see the description. And then the audience I've got not set for kids, which is what we did on the desktop. And then all you need to do is you see where it says visibility. If it was private and you came in here to actually alter that, you just click visibility and you have the same options. You've got the publish options where it's public, unlisted or private, and then you've got the schedule options, which is what we did. So if you wanted to upload on your desktop and set it to unlisted, and then if you wanted to in an hour or so come into your mobile phone and do the other bits, then you can. Now, just to say quickly that it doesn't normally take very long for the checks to be done on your YouTube Shorts, but I feel that it's very good practice when you upload a YouTube Short to YouTube to set it to unlisted to allow the YouTube AI to do those checks to make sure that there's not going to be anything that stops your YouTube Short reaching your audience the best way it can. Just by doing those simple checks and delaying it a little bit, it just makes sure that your videos are actually in line with all of the YouTube rules and regulations and there's not any copyright infringement. And what I often do is I will do those steps on the desktop and I will schedule it for a couple of hours ahead and then go into the app and just double check that everything is as it should be and let the video do what it needs to do and reach the audience that it needs to reach. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. I hope you'll be able to just stop and start it so that you'll be able to do exactly what I did for your own Instagram reels or even your own TikTok videos and repurpose them onto YouTube as YouTube Shorts. And that will be the first step in what you could consider your YouTube journey to attracting a new audience, growing in visibility, and even making your business more profitable. Now, of course, that's the beginning, and YouTube really is a marathon, not a sprint. So just you dictate how often you want to upload to YouTube. You decide if your routine on Instagram is, say, 3 reels a week, then you stick to those 3 reels a week on your YouTube channel as well. Don't forget, if you have any questions, then do feel free to reach out for me, and do keep an eye out for my next email, which tells you a little bit more about my Video Marketing Lounge membership. Okay, I'll see you soon. Bye for now.